For punishment, you will lose certain privileges, and that includes all the little bits and pieces you've recently acquired. Now, for a start, those posters. Get them down.
But I haven't.
Don't make it any worse for yourself, Daniels. Get them down now. Oh, dear, it's torn. What a pity. Let's see how strong the other is.
Mother, please, I'm sorry. I won't jump back again.
Well,
please.
You should have thought of that before you shook your mouth off, Daniels.
Let's get this straight. He won't come at blackmail.
Oh, yes, he will. His career means too much to him, not to mention the huge contract he just signed.
Not most of the taxation department gets that. He's not as rich as people think he is.
Don't sweat on it. It's not his money I'm after.
Well, what is it you're after?
Dope.
You must be joking.
Oh, no, I'm not. Believe me, I'm not. He'll make a regular delivery. Oh, it's not the hard stuff I'm after. Just some uppers and pot, maybe a little bit of hash.
Look, I don't know about that.
He'll do it. If he wants to hang on to his career and keep out of jail.
I could have slept a couple more hours this morning.
Yeah, me too. I feel as though I haven't slept all night.
You dead. You snored fit to wake the dead.
I don't snore.
You do so, and you got the nerve to talk about me.
Oh,
I don't.
Ladies, it's too early to start arguing.
Oh, it's too early for anything. God, I must be getting old, Mrs. M. All my muscles are seized up.
Are you all right?
Oh, I'll live, I suppose.
Well, if you are sick, the doctor's coming today.
Come to think of it, I do feel a bit crook. Maybe me old ticker's playing up again.
Thought you'd be interested.
Hey, when can I see him?
Sick parade's at the usual time.
Well, what's so special about the quack?
Like you four, get a move on.
Well, I saw him yesterday when he came to talk to old Davo, and he's just lovely.
Yeah? Well, I might have to mosey along myself.
Yeah.
Miss Ferguson, can I have my magazines back today?
Depends, Daniels.
What do you mean?
Depends on how you behave yourself, so let's just see what the day brings, shall we?
Rotten bitch, what's the harm in having a few dumb posters on me wall?
You ought to complain to the governor. She'd let you order more, wouldn't she?
Yeah, well, there's no point in stirring the freak up. She'd find some way of getting me back.
Yeah, the whole place has gone to the packs when she started. What's the point in having something nice if the buggers take them away from you?
Well, that's the whole point. They can't take away nothing, can they?
How's your reading going, love?
Not bad. He's a pretty terrific teacher. He reckons I'll be able to get a job in an office by the time I get out of here.
Oh, God, who'd want that?
Well, I wouldn't knock it back. If I want a legit job, I have to go fruit picking or something. Otherwise, it's back on the streets.
Oh, go on. There's always work around if you want it.
Well, not if you're covered in tattoos, there's not.
She's right, Lizzie. They'll give you a real funny look when they see your tats.
That shouldn't make any difference, not if you're willing to work.
Of course I'm willing.
Why don't you talk to Jude? I'm sure she'd help you.
Yeah, maybe you're right. Well, who do I see about it?
Why don't you ask Mrs. M? Hang on a minute. Hey, Mrs. M, Lainey wants to talk to Jude about helping her to get a job. Do you think you could arrange it?
Of course. She's due in late. I'll get her to have a word with you.
Thanks, Mrs. M.
Morning, Miss Ferguson.
Morning.
Are the girls all ready for their lesson?
They're not waiting for you in the library, if that's what you mean. They do have work to do.
Well, I realise that. You really don't approve of this project, do you?
Not for this lot.
Why not? It gives them a more positive attitude towards life. It could even stop them from coming back here.
Believe me, Mr. Maxwell, it doesn't matter what you do for these women. They'll find their way back here eventually. Now, if you'll come with me, we'll herd them up.
Thank you.
Lizzie still in there?
Yeah, I reckon he must be operating on her or something.
Well, more likely she's operating on him.
Yeah. Bit of a good looker, is he, Mrs. Epp?
Oh, he's a very nice man.
He's gorgeous. Oh, wish I was 20 years younger. He wouldn't stand a chance.
Well, what do you say? You fit for work?
Oh, yeah, of course. He just gave me some more of my pills because I was running out. He's got a beautiful bedside manner.
Well, come on, then. You better not keep him waiting.
No. G'day.
He's like Douglas Fairbanks and Errol Flynn, all rolled into one.
Maybe he should go on a diet.
Well, you can laugh, but you just wait till you see him. You'll get the hot shrimp too.
Ah, it's all right, Lizzie. It's all yours. Oh, I couldn't stand the competition.
Hello, Anderson Henley outside. Time for your reading lesson. Hey, it's Noddy in Toyland. That should keep you amused for a while. The rest of you get on with your work. All this stuff's got to be out by this afternoon.
Well, how can we when we're two hands short?
You'll just have to work harder, won't you? Now, get on with it.
You're back quick.
Yeah, I got better all of a sudden. It's truth, he's old enough to be me granddad.
Well, I didn't say he was any spring chicken. Anyway, what difference does that make?
Well, I like a mature man, but he's ridiculous.
You've got no taste. It's very refined.
Yeah? Well, I hope the next bloke they get in here has a bit more life in him.
What do you mean?
Well, he's not here for long, he told me. They only got him in here until they can find a full-time doc.
Bugger!
Cheer up, Lizzie. He wasn't your type anyway. Too stuck up. Let him go back to his blue-rinsed toffee-nosed tarts, I reckon.
I suppose so. But I like a bit of culture.
Is Julia coming today, Sonia?
I really haven't the faintest notion, my dear. You know what she's like. I sometimes wonder why she stood for the committee in the first place. Are you hungry? I'll have Connor whip you up a snack if you like.
No, I'll last out to lunch. How are the renovations on the beach house going?
Oh, quite well. Gerald has his little man. He does the most amazing things with slate. He's quite reasonable, too. So difficult to get a good tradesman these days.
And home help. You are really very lucky to get hold of Mrs. Connor.
Oh, yeah, I suppose so. Does it work, keeps to herself. Can't ask much more. Another drink?
Yes, thank you.
Connor?
Get Mrs. Belmont another drink.
Yes, Mrs. Hanlon.
With Mrs. Belmont's drink?
Yes, Mrs. Hanlon.
Mrs. Blake phoned.
No, Mrs. Hanlon. Three bags bloody full, Mrs. Hanlon.
Agitates in prison. Four letters. Now, I wonder what that can be. I've got riot, but it doesn't fit with the letters across.
I don't know. Any ideas, Mrs. Connor?
Oh, come on, Louise. Connor isn't interested in crosswords.
Stir.
What?
Stir means agitate, and it's slang for prison.
Oh. Yes, it fits. I've never heard that expression before.
Well, it's amazing what you can pick up on the telly.
Connor, my guests will be here for lunch at 1. I hope you'll be ready.
Yes, Mrs. Hanlon.
Jim and Janet have
brought
their pets to school. Janet has brought her dog. Jim has brought his...
Let the picture help you. What's Jim holding?
A turtle.
No, look at the word. It's got an S towards the end, so it's S, not all. And remember that O-R is or, not er.
Tor. I can't do it.
Yes, you can. Come on.
What's the matter, Henley? Not enough pictures?
Miss Ferguson, please.
You're wasting your time, Mr. Maxwell. Be far better off in a school teaching kids with some sort of a future. Not this lot.
Look, would you mind just doing your job and I'll take care of mine, okay?
Hello, Mr. Morris.
Carole. Oh, morning, Judy. You here to see Tina Murray?
Yeah. No joy for her, though. Looks like she's going to be another name on the Social Security list.
Oh, that's a pity. Oh, Lainey Dobson asked if she could see you as well.
Oh, sure, as long as she doesn't want me to do more tattoos.
I doubt it. Can you see
her? Yeah. If I get tired of talking to her, I can always look at the pictures.
Oh, don't, Judy. She's very sensitive about it. She actually needs a bit of morale boosting.
Well, you know me. Little old morale booster.
Have you had any experience, Lainey?
Sure. Plenty. Nothing to do with getting a job.
No, I mean... Well, what did you do after you left the girls' home? Did you go back to your family?
No way. Went on the dock.
Well, you must have applied for some jobs.
Sure, plenty. About 6 million interviews. A waste of bloody time. I went fruit picking once. Up near Mildura. Good money. But who wants to live out in the scrub? Well, it's only seasonal anyway.
Well, what would you like to do?
I don't know.
Well, there must be something. I mean, what about factory work or shop assistant?
How about air hostess?
Come on, be sensible.
Why not? Stand as much chance of getting a job as a hostie as anything else.
No, that's not true. Nobody's unemployable.
Wanna bet?
Lainey, forget about your tattoos. You have a nice personality. You're willing to work. People aren't going to care how you look.
You tell that to the blokes who do the interviews. You know, they look at you like you're something that's gone off. Oh, yeah. They're all smiles and promises. One look at the tats, and I reckon you're going to bash the place up or something.
Alison, Julia made any mention of coming here today.
Not to me.
I think she's playing golf.
Three guesses to whom she's playing with. I suppose she's entitled to her tawdry little affairs, but she might at least phone.
Well, this is excellent wine, Sonia.
Yes, it is interesting, isn't it? Gerald had it sent over from Dusseldorf on his last trip. Connor, yes. Top up Mrs. Belmont's glass, yes. Next month he's going to France. Wanted me to go with him. Swanning around the vineyards in search of some rare vintage, if you please.
Oh, marvellous. Surely you're going.
Of course not. Yes, Connor, what is it?
Well, should I open another bottle, Mrs. Hanlon?
Well, of course. No, I told him. I thought I'm far too busy. Now, this committee has a lot to do in the next couple of months, and I am not going to miss out on my trip to Hawaii in August.
Can I come in?
Of course.
I just want to use the phone, okay?
Yeah, help yourself. How'd you get on with Lainey?
Oh, well, that's uphill all the way. She's sure got a complex.
Yes, well, I told you that. You do anything for her?
Well, I'm going to try. But if I can't get her over being so paranoid about interviews... Oh. Listen, I know she's not due out for a couple of weeks, but what do you think of her chances of getting a day release? And at least then we could go job hunting.
Do you think it'll help?
Well, if it gets her over a fear of interviews, it'll be worth it.
Well, how are you going to arrange it?
I know a couple of personnel officers. They might help her.
Well, there's no harm in putting an application in. I'll speak to Mr. Davidson if you like.
Thanks.
Thought you were on duty in the library.
Yeah, I was, but I swapped duties with Helen O'Shea. Apparently she doesn't mind being abused by our kindergarten teacher.
Carole, do you have a day release application form, please?
All right, I'll get it. Hello, Wentworth Detention Centre. Yes? Who did you want to visit? Now, I'm sorry, Mr. Farmer, the department has not changed its mind. You're not permitted to visit Dobson, and that's all there is to it. No, I'm sorry, I can't answer that. Goodbye.
Who was that?
Dobson's boyfriend. He keeps ringing, wanting to visit her.
Well, I can't say I blame him, and I don't think we've got the authority to stop him. I mean, it's not as if he's got a record.
Well, take it up with the department. It was their idea.
Hey! Did I tell you the freak gave me my magazines back?
Yeah?
Yeah. The lousy mongrel practically tore them to shreds, but reckon they got torn accidentally in the storeroom. Pig's bum, they did.
Did you fix them?
Nah, waste of time. I can still read them, but...
What's up, Amy?
Nothing. Well, cheer up then. Jude'll find you a job.
Oh, what is she? Wonder Woman. She can't work miracles if you don't help yourself by pulling yourself together, love.
Oh, what's the use? I just wish Alan was here.
Struth, it's no good depending on a bloke. Anyway, I bet he'd like to see you standing on your own two feet for a change.
What do you mean?
Well, blokes don't like to have birds hanging around their necks every 5 minutes asking them what to do.
She's right, love. Not like in my young day when women were supposed to be helpless.
Look, I don't lean on him all the time. I just miss him, that's all.
We all miss not having our blokes around. But at least you had yours in here for a couple of days.
Yeah. Haven't seen him since, but... just wish he'd come and visit me.
Thank you for a lovely lunch, Sonia.
And very productive, too.
Yes, it was enjoyable, wasn't it? I think it's a better idea to have a meeting here. You know, with some decent food and wine instead of the stuffy boardroom of the club.
We'll see you next Tuesday, then.
Oh, most certainly.
Goodbye.
Bye-bye, Sonia.
Goodbye, Louise. Mm.
Bye.
Bye-bye. Connor, have the afternoon papers arrived yet?
Yes, Mrs. Helen.
Well, I think I'll have them down here. It's far too nice to go indoors yet.
That my husband will be bringing his partner home for dinner tonight for drinks. So we'll need some savouries before dinner.
Right, Mrs. Hammond.
I don't like it here, said
Heidi.
Heidi, I must go home soon.
Very good, Diane. In fact, you've all done really well today. Sounds like school's out.
Mr. Maxwell?
I told you, call me John.
I just wanted to thank you for helping me. I never thought I'd ever be able to read and write like this.
I told you, didn't I? As long as you keep practicing all the time, it won't be long before you're up to the average rate.
I was wondering, when do we get to read proper books? I mean, we keep getting ribbed about these kids' books all the time.
Don't take any notice of a bit of teasing. The important thing is to get the basics. Where you go from there is up to you.
But won't you be teaching us how to read newspapers and things like that?
Diane, I'd love to. I really would. But I'll only be here for a few more lessons. After that, you're on your own. Look, just read anything and everything you can, even if it takes you a while to work it out. You can do it.
Okay. Thanks.
Right, it's all yours.
No disasters whilst you're away?
Oh, what's this?
It's a food parcel for McKenzie. Her cousin dropped it at the gate.
All right, I'll take it to the kitchen.
What?
Well, she's not allowed to have it, surely.
Why ever not? I mean, the department's given the go-ahead for the women to receive stuff from outside.
Come on, that was only to make them look good on camera.
I'm sure the order still stands. Do you know anything different?
All right, but it'll have to be searched, surely.
I know that. I just haven't got around to it.
Well, why don't you take your break and I'll do it. Tin prawns. Apricot jam. God, McKenzie is coming up in the world. Don't you like the food in here, McKenzie?
I can take it or leave it. Why?
Your family have sent you a Red Cross parcel.
Oh, that from Bill. It's nice of him. I can see you searched it.
How'd you guess?
You left your fingerprints in the jam.
Yeah, what a mess. Oh, they don't make jars like they used to, do they?
Damn.
Oh, hell, you beat me again.
Hey, Maxie.
Yeah?
Have a look at this.
Yeah? So what?
It's a motorbike.
No, it's not. It's a tin can on wheels.
Oh, I thought you'd like it to hang on your wall, seeing the freaks rip down the others.
Oh, thanks, Lizzie. That's real good of you. But you see, this isn't a real motorbike. Now, if it was a Harley chopper or a quacker, it'd be different. But see, these things don't even have an engine. They've got an elastic band you've got to wind up.
Lainey, Judy's here to see you again.
What for?
I think she's lined up a job interview for you.
Well, I'm not getting out for ages yet.
Well, why don't you just go and talk to her?
Oh, Mrs. Sim, can't you come in here?
Maybe later, Lizzie.
Hey, Di, want to play for Lainey?
Yeah, all right.
I'll be in it too. How'd your reading go, love?
Not bad. I reckon I'll be buggered once John leaves.
But he's only just got here.
He told me just now. They only got him in to get us and me and the others started. Reckons it's up to us now.
Oh, you wouldn't read about it. First the doctor, then the teacher. Don't know why they can't get rid of the bloody screws as well.
Sounds like a waste of time to me. Well, why go for an interview now when I can't even start for weeks?
Because I want to try and show you that not all bosses are prejudiced just because you got a few tattoos.
Look, it's worth a try, Lainey. I've spoken to Mrs. Davidson. She's prepared to let you go.
Well, what's the job?
Well, it's in a dress factory. As a cutter, you cut out material to patterns. It's good experience.
It's not gonna work.
Honey, if it's your tattoos that you're worried about, then why don't you wear something with a high neck and long sleeves?
Yeah? And what about these? Gloves?
Well, you could cover those with makeup.
Oh, it's not gonna work.
Lainey, will you stop being so damn negative? I'm trying to help you.
All right. All right. I'll do it. Take a break for a while. Go and lie down in your room and relax.
Well, it's all right, Mrs. Hanlon. I've nearly finished here anyway.
Ah, I feel far too lethargic. I think I should get out for a while. I might go for a drive. Won't be long. Thank you.
cut soil last time. You turned around and abused me because it was too sharp. Well, I've got it in my pocket.
You're not going to leave me here, surely?
That's the general idea.
But why not in the house?
There's less chance of you being seen out here. Besides, you might just make your way to the phone.
My husband will be home soon.
Oh, yes, poor Jerry. You don't really suppose he'll come looking for you out here, do you? As soon as he sees that house locked up and the car gone, he'll think you're away at one of your stupid committee meetings. So he'll be here for some time, so get used to it.
Look, I'll give you anything. I'll give you some money, a head start, anything.
No, thank you, Mrs. High Society Hanlon. You've already given me quite enough already. You've taught me that just one of my mates back at Wentworth is with a dozen of you and your lot and all your so-called charity work. You know, you spend more at the hairdressers in a week than one woman normally exists on in a month. You should do yourself a favour. Down to Redfern. Newtown. With just $5 in your pocket. Just for once. See how the other half lives. You're still going to exist on that. Don't struggle too much, will you, Sonia? You might wear yourself out. Oh, and don't bother writing me a reference.
Hey, what's going on, Nola?
Hey, Di, keeping it for us, eh?
Why, what's there?
The deli's open, girls. A nice range of delicious bits and pieces, all at supermarket prices.
Well, where'd you get this lot from?
They're legit. My cousin Bill sent them in. They're no good to me, so the highest bidder gets them.
Yeah, well, what about this? Half of it spilled out.
Well, you can blame the freak for that.
How much?
$1.
50 cents.
75 cents, and it's yours. Everything else is $1, girls.
All right, can I owe you?
Oh, right. Hey, how about you, Wrinkles?
No, thank you. If you're giving stuff away, there must be a catch in it.
There's no catch. I just want to offload it, that's all. How about some tea bags? I never drink the stuff myself.
Maybe. Depends on the price.
$1.
50 cents.
Oh, Struth, here we go again. You got cash?
Screw!
Hello, girls.
Hi. Oh, good day, Jude. How are you? Lovely.
Oh. Okay, I've been visiting the girls. Hey, where's the Rosie? I think I got a job for her.
You got a regular little labour exchange down there. Haven't got any doctors on your books, have you?
No, I don't think so. Why?
Because we need one here.
I thought you already had one.
We did. He's only temporary, but...
Who told you that?
He did this morning.
Oh, I think you're mistaken, Maxine.
I am not. The teacher's going too. You asked Di.
Yeah. He said they only got him in to get us started on reading.
I thought there was something fishy about, especially since those TV blokes were here trying to show them how good everything was.
Oh, did you know about this, Mrs. Morris?
No, it's news to me.
Yeah, well, I'd like to talk to Mrs. Davidson about this.
All right, come along, let's see if she's free.
Mrs. Morris, I haven't had a phone call this week. Any chance of ringing Cousin Bill to thank him for the tucker?
All right, I'll get someone to show you through later.
So is it true then?
Yes, I'm afraid so.
Well, why weren't the staff told?
The permanent positions will be filled. It takes time. The department wanted professional help in immediately.
Oh, come on. They only did that so it would look good on TV. It's a snow job.
That's not true, Judy. We'll have full-time professional help very soon.
The last resident doctor we had here was Greg Miller. The department has supposedly been looking for a suitable replacement for the past 3 years. I mean, we haven't had a social worker since Paul Reed.
If I could help the situation, Mrs. Morris, I would. But you know how the department works. It depends entirely on budget, politics, and sheer good luck.
Well, I don't think it's good enough, Mrs. Davidson, and neither do the women.
Well, I'll explain the situation to them if you think it will help.
Yeah, sure. But then I'd stand well back if I were you. Well back.
It's ringing.
Turn. Bill, it's Nola here.
Oh, yeah. Did the stuff get past the screws all right?
I got the tucker. Thanks very much. I didn't expect it, though.
So you can just keep your trap shut about our friend?
I would, Bill. Only you didn't send the pot of honey like you said you would.
What?
It wasn't there.
Well, then the screws must have found it.
I would have found out.
Well, did you check all of them? I only put it in half.
All of what?
The tea bags. That's where the dope is hidden. There's about 20 of them in the middle of the pack, filled with grass.
obtain daring will never find us here.
Good girl.
G'day, Lizzie.
What do you want?
How's the tea?
Tea's tea. How should it be?
I was wondering if you wanted to sell it back to me.
Why?
I thought I had plenty, but I haven't. I just checked.
I thought you never touched the stuff.
I don't mind a cup of now and then.
Well, you can't have it. It's mine.
Fair enough. I suppose I can scrounge a tea bag if I want one, though, eh?
No, you can't. I bought it, I paid for it, I've hidden it away, so don't go looking for it. A lot of thieving buggers in this joint.
Stick it then, bird brain.
Come on, love. Let's get on with it.
Is it all right if I go in now, Mrs. Powell?
You've just come out.
I know, but I've just got a headache. Must be all this fresh air. I'm not used to it. I thought I might go and lie down for a while.
Well, report to the officer in reception. She'll let you through the security gate.
Hi, girls.
G'day, Jude.
Did you get on to Dava?
Yeah, I spoke to her.
Well, what's happening now?
Well, what do you think? Usual departmental runaround. Well, you can have a resident doctor, all right, when they can find one.
Yeah.
And that goes for teachers and social workers.
Oh, I knew it was too good to be true. Well, at least they let us brighten up ourselves. I suppose you can't expect miracles.
Don't you bet on it. Lizzie. I mean, how many times has someone needed a doctor in the middle of the night and they can't even get a nurse? And how many people need a social worker for some family problem? They can't get one of those for over a bloody week.
Yeah, and there's no point in having a quack 3 days a week. What happens if you get sick Tuesday or Thursday?
Yeah.
But it's always been like that for ages, so there's nothing you can do about it.
We could go on strike.
Oh, no. That'd only make the department more bloody-minded than ever.
Well, what do you reckon we write him a nasty letter and complain?
You might have something there. The passive approach could have more appeal.
Yeah. You write it, Jude, and we'll all sign it.
No, no. I will back you, but I think one of you should write it.
Who, though?
I'd do it, Jude, except I need a bit more practice yet.
Now, that is a good idea. You sit down. Anyone got any paper and pencil?
Come in.
Some papers for you to sign.
Oh, yes, thank you.
Are you all right?
Oh, as well as can be expected after being on the phone for nearly an hour.
The department?
Yes. I thought if I could harass them long enough, I might get some definite answer about this doctor business.
I take it you didn't have any luck.
No. I spoke to Ted Douglas, to the chairman of the appointments board, even to the minister's secretary. I don't like letting the women down.
Well, they can't blame you. It's not your fault.
Oh, they will, I'm afraid. I represent the establishment, and the buck stops right here as far as Wentworth's concerned.
I'm sure there won't be any trouble. I mean, Judy's with them now. She'll calm them down.
Oh, for the moment, perhaps, but there'll be more trouble. Well, I suppose I'd better go and speak to them. I don't want them to think I'm backing out of the situation. You know, with the department on one side and the prisoners on the other, I sometimes wonder whether it's worth it.
No! God, stone the bloody crows. Get a packet of bloody tea bags and everybody's your mate.
What's up, Lizzie?
Oh, bloody Angie's trying to pot me tea bags off me.
Well, you don't drink it that often anyway.
That's not the point. I paid for it and I'm going to drink it.
Well, all right, all right. Keep your shirt on. Look off at me.
Ladies, Judy has told you the situation regarding Dr. Fredericks and Mr. Maxwell. Now, I know you will be disappointed, but the department assures me this is only temporary. Funds will be made available to employ a resident doctor, a full-time teacher, and a social worker. I know you feel the department makes promises they have no intention of keeping, but that is not the case.
Mrs. Davidson, the women know you're not at fault. As a matter of fact, they're getting a letter together of protest to the department. There's a paragraph here that sort of sums up their feelings. Di, perhaps you'd like to read it.
No, I can't, Jude.
Come on, honey. My handwriting's not that bad. Give it a go. From here.
Many women are not criminals by nature, but by circumstance.
Good girl.
To take away programs that will benefit such women by restoring their dignity and
self-confidence.
Confidence is nothing
less than tragic. Well done. Now, a couple of weeks ago, she couldn't have read the first three words of that. Wonder how much better she'll be in 6 months.
Julia, dear. It was absolutely ghastly, Inspector. I quite thought she was going to kill me.
Detective Sergeant Brent, ma'am. Not Inspector, unfortunately. How long was Smith in your employ?
Oh, nearly 2 weeks.
And you never suspected her before?
Well, of course not. One doesn't expect to find a murderer under one's roof.
There have been photographs of her in the press and on television quite frequently.
I can honestly say that I never noticed them. Otherwise, I would have contacted you.
Yes, yes, of course.
Poor Sonia, what an awful experience. My dear, I am lucky to have escaped with my life.
Mrs. Hanlon, did Smith ever mention any friends he had here or any place he may have frequented?
If she did, I wouldn't know. The social life of my domestics is of no interest to me.
Did she go out much?
No, she seemed to keep to herself. Oh, I can understand why now.
How much money would she have had?
Her wages were due tomorrow. Last week she had about 200.
Right. Get on to Divvy HQ, tell them confirmed sighting and see if there's any news on the car.
I keep wondering just how long I would have lain there if you hadn't come along. Oh, my dear Julia. I shall never again curse your unreliability.
Mrs. Hanlon, there are a few more questions, I'm afraid.
Anything to put that hideous woman back behind bars.
I reckon you did real well when you read out Jude's letter.
Oh, it was terrible. I don't mind reading out loud in class. But having to read in front of the screws was embarrassing.
I think it was terrific. Come along, sit down, we'll have a cuppa. Oh, bugger, I've only got one left.
Oh, we can share it.
Oh, no way, this is a celebration. I've got plenty more. I felt sorry for Mrs. Davidson, you know. You could tell that she wasn't very happy about it.
I suppose so.
You gotta hand it to Jude. She certainly knows how to make a point. Now, if that had been me, I'd just thread it out myself. But making you read it, well, that was a stroke of genius.
Yeah, but I nearly died when she asked me.
Here you go. Oh, good. This tea looks as though it's green.
Mine's okay.
That bloody herbal stuff. I knew there was something rotten about it when she sold it to me so cheap. Well, you just sit here, love, and I'll just be back in a minute. Righto, McKenzie. You think you're the aunt's pants just because you can scare some of the other women, but you can't scare me.
What are you going on about, you old bat?
Don't you call me names and don't try any more of your tricks on me.
What tricks?
These bloody tea bags. What you put in them? Grass cuttings. Now, you just give me my money back.
Fair enough.
You give me my money back or I'll go straight to the governor and I'll tell her everything that I...
Fair enough. There you go.
Right. Yeah. Well, don't you think you can pull the wool over my eyes because I'm too smart for you?
Good afternoon, madam.
Oh, good day. Could I have a room, please?
Certainly, if you'd just like to fill that in, please.
Oh, damn, I've got to leave my paper in the taxi.
Sorry?
I left my paper in the taxi. Do you mind if I take this one?
Oh, no, no. Be my guest.
Thanks. No point having a telly in your room if you haven't got a program, is there?
Oh, well, actually, the only telly is in the lounge.
Oh.
Mrs.
Willis. Well, at least I can do the crossword, can't I? Do I pay for my room now?
Well, you can pay as you leave, if you like.
Oh, OK. Thanks.
Oh, would you like a paper in the morning?
Might as well. Can't go pinching yours all the time, can I?
Sorry, Lizzie. It's a bit weak, but at least it's real tea.
That's all right, love. It's nice of you to share it with me.
Heck, it's your tea.
Ruth, I wish the dinner bell would go. I'm starving.
You want a cuppa?
God, strike me. How'd you get the cat to sit on the cup?
It's that bloody Nola and her stupid tricks. But she won't do it again because I gave her what for.
Well, what happened?
I asked her for my money back.
And she did?
Of course she did. Stupid bitch. Stuffing tea bags with that rotten muck. But I fixed her.
Well, it's certainly not tea, that's for sure.
I've got some biscuits in my cell if you want them.
No, thanks.
Goodbye, Sally Connor. And hello, Kath Willis.
What do you want?
Lizzie tells me she sold you back the tea bags.
So?
Gonna drink them? Or you gonna smoke them?
What's it to you?
I know what's in them. We don't get dope in here. B sees to that.
B's not around here anymore.
Yeah, I know. I know you too. And I know you didn't get them in here just for yourself.
Of course not. There's plenty to go around. So long as the price is right. You can spread the word for me if you like. Nola McKenzie's back in business again.
Yeah, for a while. You were lucky getting it in. Won't be long before the screws are onto you.
Don't you believe that, kiddo. Not unless there's a lagger around here. And you know what happens to laggers, don't you? No, I'm back in business for keeps. This is only a start. I'll soon have lots. I'll have acid, grass, speed, anything the women can afford to pay for. Interested?
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain are prisoners too, when morning comes around. Last night I dreamed we were together, sharing all the love we'd known, till I had to face the nightmare of waking up alone. On the inside, the roses grow. They don't mind the stony ground, but the roses here are prisoners too. When morning comes around.